Once again, the Denver Broncos came up short, only this time it wasn't death by inches, it was murder by yards. In their 28-10 loss to Tampa Bay, the Broncos performed like a bad team does when things don't go perfectly according to plan. Vic Fangio's squad couldn't get out of its own way. Stopgap quarterback Jeff Driskel, after an admirable performance in Pittsburgh last week in relief of the injured Drew Lock, was an abject embarrassment in Week 3 versus the Tampa Bay Bucks. The Bucks' game plan was clearly to send pressure on every obvious passing set, and Driskel and the Broncos' offensive line were prepared for it. A porous O-line mixed with a QB who makes ill-advised protection calls and misses obvious blitzers pre-snap to go along with terrible pocket awareness and a stubbornness to hold onto the ball too long are not a good combination. It resulted in disaster for the Broncos on Sunday. Finally, after Driskel took a safety in the second consecutive game, again missing pre-snap pressure tells and not throwing it away, Fangio had seen enough. Driskel was pulled, and Brett Rypien entered the game in garbage time to see what he could do. What transpired, albeit in garbage time, was a much sharper and productive offense. Running tempo, Rypien moved the Broncos down the field 60 yards on 15 plays. Though it was a penalty-laden series on both sides, Rypien hung tough and completed 8 passes to 7 different receivers, totaling 53 yards. Facing a 4th-and-1 from Tampa Bay's 13-yard line, Rypien tried to look off the safety, which didn't work, and decided to push the envelope, forcing the ball to Jerry Jeudy in the end zone. It was picked off by the safety, who didn't fall prey to Rippin's eye manipulation. Rypien definitely showed a modest command for the offense and that spark that so often accompanies a quarterback change. But his arm strength limitations and inexperience don't bode well for him getting the nod to start on a short week on the East Coast at the beleaguered New York Jets. Odds are it won't be Driskel who gets the nod, but the Broncos signed Blake Bortles for a reason. Coach Fangio said he'd make a decision quickly on which QB will start this week on Thursday Night Football. Not a terrible debut for Rypien, though it was a horrid team performance by the Broncos. For Mile High Huddle and Sports Illustrated, I'm Chad Jensen.